Kilauea has been erupting pretty much continuously since 1983. What happened in early May is basically a new eruption started. This series of fissures opened up pretty reasonably far away from the park in a residential neighborhood. So all of a sudden you have lava and these volcanic gases spewing right into the area where people live. We got an email from our community partner saying there's just a huge amount of interest on the island for understanding what this all means for air quality, and basically asking if there's any way we can make more measurements than are currently being made. And for a period of just about 2 or 3 weeks, we organized this effort where we built these 30 sensor boxes and came over here to Hawaii to try to put them up all over the place.
There's three different things we're measuring. We're measuring particles in the atmosphere. We're measuring two different gases, sulfur dioxide and hydrogen sulfide. Now with this eruption, there's some concern about ash coming from the volcano as well. And so we can measure that with our particulate sensors too. We're putting sensors at schools primarily, and we are dealing with the teachers.
There's an opportunity to serve as kind of a teaching tool within the schools, both with respect to kind of environmental chemistry and VOG and hopefully other things as well.
The day that we came back after we took a week off of school, when the fissures opened and the lava started flowing, and then the day that we came back, yeah, I was during that week trying to work with Ben and getting the sensors up, and the day that we came back, I pulled it up, and we've been looking at it every morning and looking at the data and checking the air quality, which related to how people are feeling, using that data in order to understand individuals and their community. Yeah, it's been really important. We've had it up on my big projector every morning when we come in.
I think what's really exciting about this project is it connects what I do in terms of my research, which is atmospheric chemistry and air quality, with something that really matters for people right now. But there's a major concern here on the island for what this volcano means for their health and how this recent eruption could be affecting things and the extent to which they're exposed to basically additional pollution. Just the fact that we can sort of take our research efforts and apply those to answering those questions is just a really great opportunity, a really exciting opportunity.